That is a fabulous story, and that is coming up. All eyes right now on the news and breaking news. Rapid testing will be brought in to protect patients at the Royal Children's Hospital in Melbourne after seriously ill babies were exposed to COVID. Today's Christina Hearn is at the hospital for us this morning. Chris, the hospital's ramping up screening for parents and carers. Anxious wait for them.
Yeah, it certainly is, Carl. So the Royal Children's Hospital is set to announce in about an hour or so that they will be introducing rapid antigen testing for all parents and carers coming into the hospital. So that means they'll have to return a negative test. It comes back in about 10 or 15 minutes before they get entry to the hospital. It does come after a parent unknowingly brought the virus in to the neonatal intensive care unit. 29 little patients are now forced to go into isolation. Two of them considered close contacts. This is not the first COVID scare. Last week, there was a COVID scare on the Cancer Kookaburra ward. So it does raise questions as to why the rapid antigen testing was not brought in weeks or even months ago. Here's Professor Mary Louise McClure speaking on Today on Nine.
I'm surprised that people who are visiting are not tested with a rapid antigen test before they go into the ward. I know New South Wales Health were testing a rapid antigen test for cancer wards, ambulance, etc.
And we will be hearing from the hospital in the next hour or so, and we'll bring that to you as it happens. Carl?
Chris, thank you.
Victoria's case numbers this morning could confirm whether Melbourne has passed the peak of its outbreak after 3 days of declining infections. Today's Isabella Staszkowski has more. Isa, there are promising signs that lockdown will end early.
Elliot, it could be as early as next Friday. That is when we are expected to hit that crucial 70% double dose target, 4 days ahead of schedule, triggering an end to this lockdown. It would mean that hospitality, retail and hairdressers would finally be able to reopen. It certainly would be a modest easing of restrictions. However, a number of businesses have said it won't be viable for them to reopen. However, an end to this lockdown certainly would be welcome. We're now 70 days into a 7-day lockdown. And as those vaccination rates continue to rise, as you say, finally our case numbers are starting to come down. Cautious optimism that that peak has been reached. Ali?
Thanks for that, Izza.
A Sydney cafe owner has thanked the community for its support after an anti-vaxxer launched this attack.
Excuse me, what makes you think that I'm going to hand over my medical private information of whether I'm vaccinated or not vaccinated to buy a cup of coffee under this discrimination and this putrid attempt to segregate?
Today's Gabrielle Boyle joins us from the cafe in Sydney. Gabby, good morning to you. How are staff there coping?
They're doing okay, Alex. They've had a constant flow of customers through the front door this morning, everyone offering their support, and it's been this way since that awful video went viral, this anonymous man recording himself, giving them an absolute spray and then posting it online. But, of course, he didn't have the guts to show his own face and he hasn't named himself either. Locals are very keen to find out who he is. They say the cafe is just doing the right thing, protecting their community and following the health orders. A short while ago, we caught up with one of the owners.
She was upset. I was upset all night that day. I went at home and I was disappointed what happened, and I was worried what is going to happen next day.
And I tell you what, that video has backfired on the man who posted it because, as I said, they've never been busier after 20 years in the area. Lots of people have taken to social media to back the business, to offer their support. They've had loads of additional customers coming in and buying a coffee and also making donations to the business. Let's hope this is the only type of scene we see for cafes and hospitality workers in the next few days as they open their doors and try and get back on their feet, Alex.
Gabby, thank you.
Family and friends divided by the border in Queensland can reunite this morning with the restrictions easing in communities in northern New South Wales. Today, Queensland reporter Mia Glover is at the border in Coolangatta. Mia, what's the reaction there this morning?
Oh, a massive sense of relief here, Carl. Six local government areas are being welcomed back into the border bubble. That all kicked in at 1 o'clock this morning. That includes Lismore and Kyogle and the Richmond Valley. So it really means that all of northern New South Wales residents can come into Queensland now for an essential reason, as long as they've got one dose of a jab. But certainly the calls are growing louder for everyone to be welcomed back into Queensland. This week, the home quarantine trial started for about 1,000 Queenslanders who are returning home from interstate. Only around, though, 400 have taken up that invitation. Police do admit, though, that that trial will certainly pave the way for more restrictions to ease if it's deemed successful.
And if we can prove that this system works effectively, I'm sure that we can review what restrictions really need to be in place and which ones can be eased.
It's certainly the hope that so many Queenslanders interstate need, and also people who are relocating to Queensland, especially before Christmas and the festive season is here, Carl. But the Premier, though, yesterday she was grilled in Parliament, asked whether she will provide a clear roadmap to reopening the border. But she said, if we open too soon, well, we'll be in the same position as New South Wales and Victoria.
Carl? Mia, thank you.
A Queensland dad is pleading with health officials to allow him and his son to quarantine at home. Fabio Silveira and his son Lenny, who has cerebral palsy, are stuck in hotel quarantine in Sydney after returning from the US, where the six-year-old underwent brain surgery. Fabio has told Today on Nine he understands the situation but needs help.
We are talking about a six-year-old boy that needs extremely intensive rehabilitation physiotherapy program after just like 20 something days after his surgery. And we are more than keen to follow any requirements from the Queensland government.
Deputy Police Commissioner Steve Dolchevsky recommended Fabio get in contact with Queensland Health. One small step for man could soon be a giant leap for Australia as the federal government teams up with NASA for a major mission to the moon. The Australian-made $50 million rover will be sent to the moon to collect lunar soil. Bit of dirt. The launch button could be hit as early as 2026. Sport time, and the NRL board is right now, as we go to air, meeting to officially decide who will be given the licence to become Rugby League's 17th team in 2023. ARL Chairman Peter Volandi spoke to Today on Nine a short time ago, and he has a clear idea of who should coach the winning bid.
We hope that Wayne Bennett does get the coaching job. What about the first match against the Broncos against Wayne Bennett? It'll pack Suncorp Stadium, no matter which of the three teams.
Redcliffe Dolphins are the overwhelming favourites to be promoted to the top grade. Weather time now. Tim, g'day.
Alex, good morning to you. Looking very wet across Australia's east coast yet again today, but it's a bit of a reprieve today ahead of more showers and storms, particularly in southeast Queensland and northern New South Wales from tomorrow. Let's dive into our national forecast on this Wednesday for you. Looking fine up top in Cairns, mostly sunny, 33 degrees. The Sunshine Coast, Brisbane and the Gold Coast all expecting a few showers around today. A wet for Sydney once again, 20 degrees, a shower or two for Canberra. Rain developing in Melbourne. The sun's out at the moment, but there is the chance of a storm later today. 21 the high, 18 and cloudy for Hobart. Showers for Adelaide, 17. 22 the top for Perth. Looking mostly sunny. Sunny also for the Alice and Darwin. Partly cloudy, 34 degrees. Just putting the finishing touches to our final round of Tim's trivia, guys. Coming up just after 8:30.
Love it.
No, thank you, Tim.